Hello, dears. Today we have the raddest recipe. Oh my god, the recipe is so rad that it makes me speechless. That's a first. The raddest recipe. This really is the raddest recipe ever. We have the San Sebastian cheesecake. I will explain what that is because many of you don't know it yet. The ones who have been to Istanbul know for it sure. There's a cafe where people stand in line and even draw a number to get their San Sebastian cheesecake. And we've been to Istanbul twice this year. On my last Istanbul trip, last year, 2019, we walked through Istanbul for miles at night and discovered the only cafe where you can get this. By now there are surely multiple ones, and tried it. And I'll add some Insta stories for you guys. We just got the San Sebastian, the famous San Sebastian cheesecake. We got it from here. That place is packed. You can only get in with a reservation. Look, right across the Galata Tower. Awesome. Tastes like pudding. We found the San Sebastian cheesecake after 5,300 kina. And we're not alone. Yusuf and Shirin are here too. We met them here. And I haven't tried yet. I just heard what the others said first. And we were just amazed, right? It was so delicious, Hamza. Tell us, say something too. What can I say? That was the most delicious cake I've ever had in my life. Yes, it's better than anything you've ever made it. But I must say, you have already tried making the San Sebastian cheesecake here. Yes, and it was the exact same. The exact same. I closed my eyes and thought, hey, you're at the Galata Tower in Istanbul in that alley and trying that New York cheese. The San Sebastian cheesecake. That was a Freudian one. Because my favorite cheesecake used to be the New York cheesecake. Anyone who knows me knows that. And now, the San Sebastian cheesecake just topped that. So basically, why are we talking so much? Why are we talking so much? Because this is just a special video, and it's just delicious. That cake is just awesome. It's just awesome. Well, there it is. I experimented for you. This is what it looks like when I come up with a recipe. Yes, original. And it's covered in stains. Yes, that it's because I always had it on the side, and I was like, no, another egg. No. The eggs have to be 250g. That answers the question where you get your recipes from. You come up with them. Yes, I always come up with them myself. Yes, I experimented for you. And these are the ingredients. You can get them in any standard German supermarket. Here I have cream cheese. Please do me a favor and don't use the salty versions. And no light or low fat one. Full fat cream cheese that doesn't taste salty. I already have it in my kitchen machine. I'm just adding the sugar now. And we're going to mix that with the stirring attachment. I'm using the one with the rubber lining so it gets to the edges as well. Around 10, 15 secs. And a small tip, the cream cheese and all other ingredients should be room temperature. Otherwise, you'd end up with small cream cheese lumps that don't combine with the homogeneous mixture. So it's best if they are at room temperature. Now, 10, 15 secs and then I'll see you again. Please don't stir for too long or the cream cheese will become liquid. We don't want that, it should remain firm. And really, really important for this recipe, we are not beating anything. We don't beat any air into the mixture to keep it as creamy as possible. Now I have some starch here that I'm sifting, really important. Sift it so there won't be any lumps. And I did try using flour instead, but I didn't like that, so definitely stick with starch. Okay, sift that in and give it a quick stir. Cracked the room temperature eggs and gave them a stir. Also really important, don't beat them. Don't use a mixer or anything to incorporate air because that is the opposite of what we want. Now I'm slowly stirring this into the cream cheese mix suit. At a low setting and just long enough for the cream cheese and the eggs to combine. As always, the eggs of happy chickens that can move around freely taste best. For the next step, we're adding the lemon juice and room temperature whipping cream, also vanilla extract. The vanilla extract is really the most important ingredient in this recipe. The San Sebastian cheesecake has a really dominant vanilla flavor. You really feel like you're biting into real vanilla and not artificial flavors. So please do me a favor and don't use any vanillin sugar. Vanillin sugar, as the name tells you, it's not even called vanilla sugar because it doesn't contain any vanilla. It's just artificial flavors and you can taste that. And of course you can get vanilla extract in my shop. It's alcohol free and comes in a squeeze bottle. It contains real vanilla and you can taste that. And if you don't have any at home because you didn't order it online from me, then use vanilla sugar, but of course it doesn't compare to the extract. And as soon as you've quickly mixed that in too, our mixture is done and ready to be prepared for the oven. I cut myself. Those small cuts hurt the most. I even shed a tear, so if my eyes look glassy, that's why. But it's all good because I know what's awaiting me. A San Sebastian cheesecake, so it's all good. I have the 20 centimeter springform ready here. You have to make sure that the bottom is lined, and unlike my other recipes, we have to line the edge of the springform too. So add some parchment paper there with baking spray or water from a spray bottle, your choice. I find baking spray more reliable so the edge stays put, and it's really important that it doesn't fall in. Now we're filling in the cheesecake mixture and baking it. And the baking setting is 240 degrees with circulating heat, and it's going to take 31 to 32 minutes at most. And first we're going to tap the cake pan a few times, I'll show you that. But we'll remove the sound, that's pretty loud, Hamza, so the bubbles come out. Can I tap it if you want? Sure. Let out some of the aggression? Yes, sure. Should I do it now? Yes, like this. Yes, lift it or lift it and then just let it drop. Ah, you can do it more violently to get rid of the bubbles, right? Yes, it gets rid of the bubbles, making everything creamier. By the way, to prevent any frustrations at home, you will need an absolutely secure springform for this recipe to make sure nothing leaks. I'm linking you mine in the description box, as well as all utensils and ingredients, of course. And then I'll see you after the baking. Okay, the San Sebastian cheesecake is done. Really, really, really important. After the baking time, take it out of the oven right away. I usually advise you to leave cheesecakes in the oven and let them cool out there. But you can't do that here. The whole point of the San Sebastian cheesecake is its core that isn't liquid, but rather tenderly melting and soft. And now you have to be really strong. Promise me, let it cool off. At least for 4 hours, you could also leave it overnight. I just let it stand uncovered at room temperature and I'll see you in 4 hours. After the cooling time, just remove the edge of the springform and the parchment paper, but I'm leaving the cake right where it is because I'm so impatient right now. I just want to cut this San Sebastian cheesecake now to show you the consistency. Oh, the knife is just gliding through the cheesecake. It's totally normal that it looks so burned. Absolutely, it even has to. So people don't start writing. No, it's completely normal. And here it comes, the moment of truth. I do it slowly so it looks really great. And that's it, that's it. Exactly this, that wetness, that moist core. Oh my God, perfect. This is the San Sebastian cheesecake to perfection. And what you have to do now, grab a plate and don't lay it down this way, but this way. Oh, yum. And there you have it, the original San Sebastian cheesecake. And I'll tell you why it's original. The San Sebastian cheesecake is known, like I said, for that soft, tenderly melting vanilla core. It tastes a little bit like really, really tender vanilla pudding, but not the one you know and you stir and then it firms up, but just really tender as if it was made of clouds. Okay, What's also really, really important to say, we bake this at a very high temperature, stop then and take it out after just 30 min, which is very unusual, but that's how we get this hard exterior. By hard, I just mean firm like a normal cheesecake, a little bit like the New York cheesecake. And now I'm just going in with my spoon and, oh my God, that's what I'm talking about. That's exactly what I'm talking about. And I'm going to try it for you. Yes, for us, right? For you, of course. Yeah, sure. Mm. Oh my God. This is the most delicious discovery of my whole entire last year. I mean, I am a cheesecake freak and I always loved the New York cheesecake more than anything. But sorry, this just tops it, really, really delicious. Just try it out. If you don't eat it, you're really missing out. You're really, really missing out. Because like I told you in the beginning, I was like, what are you all on about? Why do you all want to eat a burned cheesecake? I kept asking Hamza, why are people sending this to me? Well, now I know why, and I'm just glad I discovered this. And now you definitely have to make this. Hamza, we're going to calmly enjoy it and definitely make this. As always, I left you the exact measurements in the description box. Definitely subscribe. It's completely free if you like this video and you... If you like this video and you want to see more recipes like this, popular recipes, just let me know. I experiment for you and then make it for you, so definitely subscribe. I hope you have a lot of fun baking this and I'll see you in my next video. Bye! Hamza, come eating now, finally, finally. And in Istanbul, it was so that melted chocolate was then poured over it. So in my case, I had whole milk chocolate, and I have to say with the mixing together, it tasted like an extremely awesome kind of regal cake, and I'll demonstrate it to you. So if it's right, then that you look so good. But now I'm really saying goodbye, so see you soon, bye.